All right, guys, we're going to take a little break from working, and I think that we're going to run over to Green Base, I believe it is, and find Mr. Funky's room and put a little bit of floating sand in his room and maybe a sign down that says, you know, hey, Mr. Funky, I heard you needed a lot of sand. So, and then, you know, shouldn't be too hard for him to clean up, but whatever, it'd be kind of funny when he records it, so. All right, guys, we're over here in the green base over here at Mr. Funky's room, and I had a plan of filling this room with floating sand, but it's kind of funny seeing the just a room full of peonies. I think I'm gonna go ahead with the floating sand thing here, but we can maybe do the. Oh, it fell through. I guess I have to do it from down here. There we go. Just place on top of the others. Let's get rid of this guy here. Place another peony. All right. Oh, this is going to be difficult. It's hilarious, though. It really is hilarious. Maybe we can, if we, here, let's do this. Let's do this. Can we get up and over? Ah, there's not enough room. Let's just break. Ah, it's forever. Wasn't prepared for that. All right, drop back down, come back around. That'll work. There we go. Now we can walk on it. Yeah. When we get done here, we can go down to the bottom and break all these peonies, and the sand will just continue to float. Hopefully the floor is getting lit down there, because if it is, then we won't have to worry about mobs spawning down there because of the sand blocking the light. He's been sitting there AFK, didn't even know he was logged in. I guess it's a good thing a creeper didn't come after him. Yeah. Oh, this is going to be beautiful. Now, oh, let's leave this one open, actually. Let's go from this corner. Hopefully, when he logs in, he'll have plenty of... Can I get up there? Yeah. We should have plenty of sand to do this, yeah. Let's just get rid of that one. I'm going to fill all these in here, as much sand as we possibly can. And hopefully this won't kill him with suffocation damage. Hopefully he realizes to either get out of the way or dig himself out when it falls on him. Not sure. But... I want to go ahead and fill it all the way up, because if we don't, then he's going to get creepers up here and blow up his base. He don't really want that. Oh, man. But he's kind of working on a project, from what I understood, that needed a lot of sand anyway, so that'll just get him partway there. He won't have to go pick it up. It'll already be at his base. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We are almost there. Let's see. Oh, yeah. So let's check light levels just to make sure. I think we're still good. Light. Oh, yeah, he's still good all the way around here. So many pumpkins. Let's see. Should be able to get rid of all of that there. And the sand is just going to float. Let's take that F3 off the screen there. Yeah, oh yeah, this is going to be beautiful. Well, guys, we're out here in the nether doing a little tidying up. I AFK'd here for quite a long time and then came down to the platform to turn the machine off and got wrecked. So, knocked off the platform. So, I figured I'd already talked to Cowboy about doing some filters on the gold farm drops here. So, figured I would go ahead and make the platform just a little bit safer for us to come down and turn the machine off, because if you can't turn the machine off and you get knocked off the platform or die, then this whole contraption just can break because the chunks become unloaded. So I'm gonna go ahead and resolve that issue while we're out here, as well as fixing the storage problem. That way Cowboy doesn't have to come out here and do it. He's a busy guy, so yeah, we got room for that. Cool. Alright guys, I'm gonna get this done and I'll let you guys see what I've gotten done with it when I'm done. Alright guys, we're over here AFK, and finally I've made some adjustments to the farm here, and if we can get XP out of her face, I added a filter down on each side that's going to drop out the swords for us so that we don't have to worry about those and any armor that may happen to come into the system. It's going to get automatically spit out about halfway down the line on each side there. So that we should just get nuggets and ingots and some rotten flesh in there. And we'll see how that does. If we need to, we'll go back and add a filter for rotten flesh. And that way we can just get the gold we're looking for. And I don't know, maybe I'll work on getting a cleric or two up here for the rotten flesh. It may be beneficial, may not be beneficial, I don't know. But I just really wanted to take and do a little bit here to help the server out in general. Cowboy did a great job building this thing, and he stays real busy all the time, so it's just one thing I could do to help out, and so he didn't have to. So anyways, I'm going to AFK here for a while. And another thing to point out that I did was to add glass down here around all of this, and for the most part it's going to keep the zombie pigment out. A few could come from up there, and just like this baby pigment here, he fell through one of the one wide gaps. I mean, they're gonna get in still, but it's not as bad, and you're not gonna fall to your death. They may kill you, but you're not gonna fall to your death as easily. So there's that. Anyways, I'm gonna jump back into doing some other things here, and we'll bring you back in at the next project. All right guys, we are now gonna start a project. What I really want to do is build a nether wart farm. I want to be able to get some of these blocks here, and I also want to be able to have the nether wart for possibly a potion shop here soon. And I've got a couple things to work. There's a blaze spawner that I'm going to be working on very soon, so that'll give us that. And sugar cane, we've got it growing over there by the house, and you can't see it, but that's okay. And you know, we can gather the other things that we need. But so basically water spreads like this. And so all we need to do is take and build soul sand platforms that the water covers, that covers the water coverage. And also build a redstone mechanism to fire those things. So each level will have a dispenser and a water bucket, and it'll all fire, and eventually we'll have tons and tons of these. So let's get started on that, and hopefully it'll be pretty epic. I'm thinking about going really over the top of this thing, so yeah. All right. All right, guys, so I got the space that I need here laid out for my growth floors, and so what we're gonna do is build our redstone mechanism. So first thing, this will be our first growth floor, and it's two blocks up, so we can walk under it if we need to. And I'm gonna place a redstone on there, and then I'm gonna not that. I'm going to come down one block right here. And I'm going to look at the redstone and I'm going to place that. And then I can break the redstone off. All right. And then we're basically going to just continue doing something like this all the way up. Redstone, observer, break the redstone, come up, place a dispenser. And a redstone. And this is how I'm going to build this all the way up. And the reason we're doing it like this is so that the observer is facing the sky like that. All right, I'm going to get, I guess I'm going to go 64 high as far as layers. So we're going to have 64 growth layers, and this is going to be pretty high in the sky. So, hey, guys, we are back here. And got all these levels here. I gotta be honest, I cheated out a little bit and I was gonna build up to the limit, but I started realizing that was pretty tedious. So there's 19 layers here, and there's gonna be more than we can collect at one time anyway, so I think that's gonna work for us. Now what we have to do now is we have to come up with some sort of a design to and I'm got ghost key problems right now. I'm not touching the mouse or keyboard right now. But yeah, we got to build a box around this thing, and I've got a bunch of glass that I'm been trying to get smelted up. And I don't want to just use glass. I'm also going to use some nether brick, and it's black in its texture pack as we see on the house there. And so we'll use a lot of nether brick and a lot of glass, and we'll do see if we can't get a nice good looking tower around this thing to make it look pretty epic. So let me gather the rest of the materials together and we will get started building that and figure out what's wrong with my ghost key problem here. All right. All right, guys, we got a little bit of a design laid out here. I basically just wanted to come out one block. Leaving enough room for all of the nether wart to fall straight down the sides here. We'll do some kind of water drop to the middle afterwards. I don't think that I've got enough materials at the moment to completely finish this part. But we're gonna give it a go. So basically we're gonna come up one to three blocks to be level with this. Now that way, every time the nether ward's gonna have to fall one side or the other here, it shouldn't get trapped in any way. And at this level, I'm gonna come in with, let me come back over here a little ways. I'm gonna come in with glass. Yeah, I'm going to come in with glass here at this level. That way you can see the nether wart from, passing, or you're flying by, you can actually see the nether wart growing. I think that's going to be a pretty neat design. Hey guys, welcome back here. And as you can see, I did a whole lot of work on this thing. Probably got carried away and actually got it all done here. I destroyed a whole bunch of a nether fortress for all this nether brick, and that is looking massive, isn't it? Oh man, but it's not done. I'm not sure. I want to add some detail to it. It looks pretty beautiful just as it is. Oh, baby zombie. Oh my goodness. Come here. Get wrecked. Get wrecked. Oh, this stupid grass. Baby zombie. Oh my goodness. Whew. That's just about death right there. All I don't have any food. I get some food. There we go, some pork chops. That'll work. Goodness. Okay. Back to this. I got a little carried away. I'd built it up here, and I've already harvested it once, and I did it all manual, and then I started adding this collection system in here. Got a whole bunch of iron from Cowboy, and thank you, Cowboy, for the iron. Couldn't have done it without you. And we harvested words today. Harvested this thing once, and this is what it gave us, was two double chests plus this here. And I went ahead and made this 1, 2, 3, 4. It looks like 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 5. Probably might need to add more to it. I don't know, because we've already got this much. So what I'm going to do here is make some ladders, because we got a ladder up there. And I also need some trap doors, which I believe I already made those, but I'm not sure what I did with them, and they're not there. So let's come look in our little hole here and see if we can locate any trap doors. Not those ones. No. No. Are they in here? No. I'll take those, though. And the wood, because I need ladders. And the sticks, because I need ladders. Oh. Look, there's Nina's green carpet. Maybe I should take that back to her later. Sheer trapdoors. Okay. And trapdoors. Okay, so what we're going to do with this is, because this is going to be the entranceway, I'm going to place ladders here, and then a ladder there. And then these trapdoors here can be just like that. Ladder, trapdoor, ladder, trapdoor, ladder, trapdoor, ladder. All right, guys, our ladder's in. We're gonna come down here and dump our inventory completely. And so let's dump all of our inventory in here. And we also do need, we still have a few torches here. We'll take those up with us, and that's it. I want to light, there's one section that we need to light up. And so what I want to do is take a full inventory, and we're going to keep track of how many nether wart it actually took to plant this thing. So we'll start from the bottom and go up, and when it's done, I'll let you guys know.
Are you back?
Oh, okay. Hey, what's going on?
Oh my! What did you do to me?
I figured I would protect you.
Oh well, that's very nice. Is that the nether wart block?
Yeah.
I actually really like that. That looks like a cool building.
So that's kind of part of the reason why. Hold on just a second. That's part of the reason why I wanted to build the farm.
Makes sense.
Is for the block, and because also I'm thinking about doing like some kind of potion brewing thing.
Ooh, I want to make tavern. I don't know how. I've never brewed in this game either.
Do what?
I've never brewed potions in the game either.
I fell in a hole.
Oh dear.
So yeah, but this should produce plenty. But you need nine stacks of netherwart to make a stack of netherwart blocks. So this is not really like if you're gonna use a lot of netherwart block, it's not really a ridiculous amount of yield. You kind of need it, you know.
That is very true.
So.
I don't know if I'd actually use it a lot, maybe as an accent piece. That's about it.
Yeah, so my plan is, and I'm gonna go ahead and tell you, I've got it recording, by the way,
Okay.
because I'm telling you about it, is to. Ooh, there's a lot of mobs out here. It's
Run away, run away.
a lot of mobs. I don't. I'm either bone block or quartz, but basically make mushrooms to stick out the side.
Little netherwort mushrooms, I think.
Yeah, I'm gonna stick them out the sides of the tower here, and
I like
like,
that idea.
I and then I'm also gonna like plant them around the area here. I don't know. I'm gonna try to get some podzol or some mycelium.
I need podzol too, because I plan
And
on using mushrooms.
yeah, and tons of mycelium or podzol one, and plant make these and use like bone block or quartz for the stem, and then like do a
I
like a
think bone block
dome.
might be better.
Yeah, I do too.
Quartz might be too polished.
Yeah, I agree. And or it could, well, you can't really use diorite in this texture pack,
No, it's meh.
but it would work. It would work in the vanilla pack. But anyways, that's kind of my thoughts. I think,
I like that idea. That's
but
kind of cool.
these are gonna grow off of the tower though. As it goes up, it's kind of like they're gonna be like sticking out. I'm gonna go sleep.
Yes, please. I like that idea though. It's different. I've never seen anyone use it like. I like seeing new things.
Yeah. Well, I think I've seen it before, but
Don't
it's
remember where.
think Etho may have done it. I'm not sure.
I killed a zombie. I'm proud.
But how cool would it be for like mushrooms to just be branching off of this tower here? Yeah, you liking that bow I gave you?
Oh yeah, it's fun. I'm still chicken to go outside though. So.